shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thou doest prepare a table before the presence of my enemies. Thank you. Amen. Bless her, bless her, bless her. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God is good. God is good. God is good. God is good. Sister Sarah Dabney. Amen. And want to say, I have to say this, that Pastor Perry Dabney and Sister Sarah truly were soulmates.
Yes.
Soulmates. Soulmates. And some folk, they together today, gone tomorrow. 3 months, amen, and they in divorce court. But I can say today that they were soulmates. They truly loved one another. Amen. And I just want you to look at your neighbor. I ain't preaching, we got somebody on here.
Shield and buckler.
That's right.
For he shall give his angels charge.
charge over me.
Yes.
To keep me in all thy ways.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Can we say amen?
Amen.
Sister Sarah, I have to piggyback on that. I ain't been married as long as you and Pastor Beard. Dabney was married. That's 45 years, man.
Thank you. Yeah,
I'm saying that, and I'm
Amen.
Because I'm hurting like they're hurting. Because they all come here.
anything. Always, I've always been the family man.
Yes, yes.
So,
yes.
My sister, yes.
Amen.
Sarah, can you call Gwen? The
because I wanted to sing a song to her. And he would call me and he would sing. He would sing My Angel. And I would just break down and cry on the phone. But God has found you here. You are now his angel. And the song was, I Gotta Find an Angel.
Beautiful.
But God has found you now here. He has found his angel. And may God bless you and bless the family. And we all have to come together.
Amen.
And be here for the family.
Mm-hmm.
Always say, when you get a nickel, my dad, God did it for me.
right here. Granddaughter.
Yeah, that's what it is.
But I'm old.
But granddad, did you want to say a little something? Okay, would you stand up? Amen. Amen. All right. Get the mic. Okay. Get the mic.
I wouldn't be too much to speak in front of a lot of people, but it's my granddad.
All right.
He made the wealthy. I didn't really have my dad, so my granddaddy stepped in. And even though I don't want the best kid growing up, but my granddaddy was the only thing that was so he was always there when I needed somebody to laugh or somebody to smile.
Right.
Even at my baddest moments, my granddaddy never judged me.
Yes.
And I know he's still here. Mm-hmm. I feel his presence in every situation.
Wow.
I feel the word. Yeah. I still say that granddaddy because I know he's still here.
Amen.
And grandma, I love you.
Amen.
I'm sorry. But yeah, granddaddy, he's still here with me regardless.
All right. Just a minute. Granddaughter, what's your name?
I'm Tori.
That's it. What you say? I know I'm old, but anyway, thank God. We thank you for those words of expression of your granddad.
Hallelujah.
All right, I think I have room for to be here. My friend, amen, Brother Danny Lyon.
We did a lot of traveling together. We did a lot of traveling. Went to state fair out there. Skating.
Yeah.
A lot of things. Movies.
Yes.
We done.
Mm-hmm.
Sarah, the last one we went to was that. We went to that park.
So that is okay. You planted the seed, you know.
But my daddy's favorite song is I Have a Father Who Can. Y'all remember he sung it all the time.
Oh yeah.
And although he was talking about a heavenly father, that's how I felt about my father. Yeah. Like, I have a father who can.
Yeah.
It wasn't anything that my daddy couldn't do, didn't know.
Well,
period. Like, I, you know, a lot of people say, oh, my dad, this and that. My daughter said the other day, she was like, she said, she told one of her friends, whatever, she said, oh, my dad can fix anything. And if my dad can't fix it, oh, then it's truly broken.
Oh.
And I was like, that's my daddy. I was like, that is my daddy. My dad would say, you know, I'd take my car to the shop and it'd be like $2,500.
Ooh, Jesus.
My dad would like, if you can get the car to me, I can fix it. I'm like, no, daddy, they told me, you know, something's $2,500. I need to jump in to do this. Drop cars in my head. Just get the parts. My dad, and it's so crazy. Like, he was just self-taught with everything. I was so impressive. He took a bicycle for Christmas and take it all apart just to put it back together. So he just,
I understand.
Bring the car to my dad. Boom, big coming. He goes to school for being a mechanic. I mean, even though, you know, he's old, not old, whatever you want to say, but he can Google, YouTube, get a manual out, and the best thing to tell him is he can't do something,
uh-oh.
And then he's going to tell you how he can. He's going to show up and show out for everything. Y'all know that. Tell him he can't do something, he going to do it. That's it.
That's the baby talk, okay?
Don't worry about him. And you know, a lot of people that know him, y'all know that my dad was very proud of him. Very proud. He wasn't gonna ask you for nothing. He wasn't gonna ask you for nothing.
Right.
Because he knew. You know what I'm saying? And if he got down on his luck and ever asked you for something, please consider yourself lucky and blessed. But that ain't something that he does.
Right.
From him, gosh, I'm all over the place. But I had a dad that could fix cars. He went from fixing cars to woodworking to baking cakes. Like, this man was a jack of all trades. It don't get better than that. Like, he can bake cakes. He can cook.
Oh, that's good.
Yes.
Fix the car, mow grass, clean up. Like, I was like, dang. But you know, he did.
Oh, yeah. That's true. Yeah. Hallelujah.
You know, let me see. But, anyways, Yeah, even in my dad's tiny house, I was very proud. I was very self-sufficient. Mm-hmm. And like I said, even in this declining health, nothing changed. You still was proud, you still was self-sufficient. Even when I would give him some juice or whatever, he would have just a little doubt when he wasn't. When you seen him, he looked good. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I looked good. Kind of get it from him, but you know. he had a little, like, insure or whatever. Mm-hmm. And he would, with the little strength that he had, he would, I'm like, hey, just a little bit. He was still very proud, even in those moments. He wasn't a little mess. But after all this, I believe we all have an expiration date. God is a healer, and I know that he could have healed, but it just wasn't in his will.
There you go.
But one thing I can say, that he gave him 70 years. What they say, 3 scores plus 10, and he gave him
70
years. So, thank God that he gave him them 7 years.
Seventy
was a great number.
Yes.
And he lived.
Yes. Yes.
So I'm happy. Like I said, my daddy traveled. He was married to the love of his life.
Yes.
50 years. He had the best daughter in the whole wide world.
Because he was driving me.
kids, it's like, we got better. Mm-hmm. So my mom does things to stay away from them. Mm-hmm. So Tudor decides we're going to give them some chicken. Mm. So Tudor brings Daddy a chicken. I'm not going to say he couldn't see, he was visually impaired because that's what he used those
right.
So he felt on a plate and he felt the chicken and he felt skin on the chicken. Mm-hmm. So he asked Tudor, told you to give me this chicken. He said, he knew the right word to say, he said, Sarah. He's like, Sarah ain't told you to give me this chicken. He said, why you say that? He said, no, this chicken got skin on it. Sarah, don't feed me no chicken.
Thank you. Best. Yeah.
He's still there.
I am God.
That's just like God.
Yes.
He's still there.
Yes.
Even when you mess up,
yes.
He's still there.
Yes.
Even when you slip, he's still there. Yes. Even when you fall, he's still there.
Yes.
So I'm telling you, he gave you his very best.
Yes.
But not only that, I'm going to conclude in a few minutes.
That's all right.
I ain't going to take all day. So I'm trying to engrave it in your mind.
Yeah.
that you got to live right. You got to be born again. You got to step out of the woods. Amen to God. And what I love, Sister Renee, one thing about God, God is a holy God. God don't change. God don't have no respect. If I got to live holy, you got to live holy.
Come on.
You don't want me to do it?
Come on.
Because I ain't going to lie for you. If you go to hell, I'll say, guess what? God has an ugly thing. He's the judge. But as far as I know, they going to hell. So you can prevail in the secret place.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Today, my brother is in the secret place.
Hallelujah.
Of the Most High.
Yes,
that song that Brother Green read was one of his favorite songs.
Wow.
Put it in the secret place. He had no idea that he was going to dwell there at that day. But he knew the day will come.
Yes.
That he had to go to the secret place. So he was preparing himself to go to the secret place. I understand ministry. A lot of people don't understand ministry. A lot of people think ministry is having the greatest church, the biggest church. They think that's ministry. Ministry works every day of your life. Do you realize, ain't no telling how many people have been touched by him? How many times he witnessed to somebody? Do you have any idea? He probably had no idea how many people he even talked to over the last 40 years doing Bible class and Sunday school. And going out, we used to go out together as a team to do missionary work together. We did it one day, and Pastor David stopped us and said, "You and Brother Perry not going out together. Y'all gonna have to split up and put that in a different team because somebody else needs you. So y'all need to split that team up. We don't need both of y'all in the same team." I said, "Well, I thought you said, y'all split the team up. You go one with somebody, and he go with somebody else. Come on, somebody." Because they understood ministry.
Absolutely.
Ministry is your life.
Yes.
And that's witnessing to everybody.
Amen.
Did you come in contact with?
Amen.
The Lord's family is in ministry.
Amen.
Can I say that?
Amen.
He's here.
Come on.
Amen.
God wants you to be the best that you can be. I ain't the only one that God. God wants you to be the best that you can be. of the Spirit of God.
Yes.
So if you ain't fooling one thing, you fooling something else.
Amen. Yes.
Hallelujah, brother.
So I don't know what you're fooling, but it ain't the Holy Ghost. When you're fooling something, I gotta watch you. God wants you to be fooled.
Yes.
If you're not married, you shall be quit.
Yeah.
Amen.
Thank you.
I forgot about that spot. I know one time we went to Fix Flag or something. They said that this hotel, you know, back then I had 16 hours very much money. We stopped in the same room.
Diane Williams, Jeanette Heinz, and Mary James. You'll come forward.